This DaVinci Resolve Studio tool is going to revolutionize the way you work. Am I exaggerating? Judge for yourself. You'll be able to remove the background from any video. Blur the background to achieve a bokeh effect, place titles behind people and objects, and help you create visual effects. Yes, all of this and more using just one tool. In this video, I'll show you how to use the depth map effect in detail and unlock all of its potential. So let's get started. Before using the depth map effect, it's advisable to know what kind of video to use it in. The videos in which you can get the most out of this tool are those in which there's a person or object close to the screen and clearly differentiates from the background. In this example, the woman and the table are clearly different from the background. This video would also work. People in the front and a background. Here, more of the same, a person close to the background. I think you get the idea. Videos where there's depth, that is, elements that are close and far from the camera. Okay, with that said, let's start using the depth map effect. First of all, we need to go to the color module of DaVinci Resolve and open the effects menu located in the top right. Here, we'll look for the depth map effect. We select the effect and drop it onto the node panel, making sure the node with the effect is well connected. Perfect! Once the effect is applied, the depth map will appear in the viewer. DaVinci Resolve has analyzed our video, and as you can see here, the silhouette of the woman and the table appears, and the background is black. This means that DaVinci Resolve is capable of distinguishing the distance between the elements in our video. And thanks to this, we can achieve great things with our video. To switch between the original video and the depth map, simply activate or deactivate the option Depth Map Preview. We can modify the quality of the depth map. If your computer doesn't have much power, I recommend selecting the faster mode to use the effect correctly. You may be wondering, what exactly is this depth map? What is this white silhouette and what do I do with it? Don't worry, it's very simple. With the depth map, we'll be able to select elements and parts of our video according to their distance. The parts of the depth map that appear in absolute white are the parts that are 100% selected, while the gray colored parts are those that have less selection. That is, if I now make a change to the depth map, for example, increasing the brightness of the video, it would affect the white parts much more than the gray ones. Easy, right? The black colored parts are the parts of the video that are not selected. Great! And now, how would we adjust the parts that are selected in the depth map? For example, remove any grays that may be in the background and have the woman and the table completely selected in white. Adjusting this selection is very simple. We just have to activate the option to adjust map levels. To separate the background from the person and the table, it's necessary to modify the limits of distance. To remove more parts of the background, we increase the far limit. If you want to select the woman and the table completely, you have to decrease the near limit until everything appears in white. It's important to note that it's not always necessary to separate into black and white. It all depends on the result you want to achieve. For example, if you want to apply a blur using the depth map tool, it's recommended that there be gray areas. In my case, I'm going to completely separate the person from the background. We can further improve the selection by using the option Isolate Specific Depth. If we activate the isolation option, we achieve greater separation between the person and the background. Then, by modifying the tolerance and softness, we can adjust the selection more precisely. For example, if we increase the tolerance, we can fix some errors in the selection and get a perfect result, as we can see how this error we had here has been fixed. If you want the selection edges to be smoother, we can fix it in the Map Finesse. Here, we can create a gradient or blur at the edges to make them look even better. If we activate the post-processing function, we can see how it creates a blur at the edges, adding gray areas. In the post-filter adjustment, we can increase or decrease this gradient. I'm going to decrease it. Personally, I recommend using the refinement option, as we can achieve better results. For example, if we look at the original video with refinement, we've applied grays in areas such as hair. I don't recommend modifying the contract/expand option, as it serves to increase or decrease the size of the selection. Finally, we can apply a small blur to the edges. Very little, 0.04 would be enough. Perfect, we now have the depth map just as I wanted it, completely separating the woman and the table from the background. Remember that in this example, in the depth map, I separated it into black and white because my intention is to completely separate the woman from the background, as if making a mask. But in most cases, it's recommended that there be gray areas in the depth map, since if we only have black and white, we don't have depth. That being said, I will quickly show you some uses we can give to the depth map. The first thing we have to do is create a new corrector node and connect it to the effect node and with the output, with this green circle. Now, we must connect the blue output of the effect node with this small blue arrow of the new node. Perfect. We now have everything ready. Now, any changes we make in this new node will only affect the part that we've selected with the depth map. For example, we can change the color of the selected area. This would work well to achieve the same blue tone of the background in the woman and the table. In this case, I am exaggerating the color change so it can be seen clearly. We can also reduce the saturation so that the selection appears in black and white while the background remains in color. Anything can be done. It's exactly like having a mask. For example, if we want the woman and table to appear less illuminated to better match the background, we can reduce the highlights. This way, we can adjust the lighting to our liking in specific areas. These are just a few examples of what can be done with this tool. Great! In case you want to invert the selection of the depth map, that is, instead of having the woman and table selected, having the background selected, it's very easy to do. We must select the node with the depth map effect and then activate the invert option. Now, any changes we make to this node will only affect the background. Well, now that we have the entire background selected, we can achieve one of my favorite effects. We can blur the background of any video. To blur the background, we just need to search for any blur effect. The Gaussian blur effect would work well. We select the effect and apply it to the last node we created. Now the background will appear more blurred. Here you can see the before and after applying the blur. We can adjust the effect to our liking in the Gaussian blur settings, increasing or decreasing its intensity. Now I'm going to show you how to remove the background from any video. That is, even if your video doesn't have a green screen, you can remove the background using the depth map effect. The first step is to add a node with the depth map effect. Great. Since we want to remove the background, the entire background should appear completely black, and the part we want to select in white, exactly like in the previous example. In the resulting map adjustment tab, we activate the option to adjust map levels and increase the far limit to remove the background, increasing until the background is completely black. Perfect. The next step is to make the silhouette of the person appear completely white. To do this, we decrease the near limit until the selection appears white. Great, we finished our depth map selection. To be able to see the original video again, we deactivate the depth map preview. Let's remove the background. We right-click on the node panel and search for the option to add alpha output. By adding an alpha output, a blue circle will appear on the right side. This is the alpha output. We need to connect the blue square from the depth map effect node to the alpha output like this. Perfect. As you can see, we've already removed the background from our video. Now, let's focus on improving our selection. The selection edges are a bit rough. There are jagged edges. To improve the selection edges, we can go to the Map Finesse. We activate the option Post Processing, and we adjust the post filter setting to make the edges much smoother. Great, now the selection is much better than before. Finally, if we go to the Editing module, we can check that the video does indeed appear without the original background, and we've been able to remove it without needing a chroma. Adding any background you want to the video is very simple. We just need to place any other video below it. For example, I'm going to add this clip of the clouds. We place it below the original clip, and there you have it. You can add any background you like. Now I'm going to show you how to place text or any element behind an object or person using the depth map, exactly as you're seeing on the screen. The first step is to duplicate our clip. We can copy and paste it on the timeline. We now have the video duplicated, so we can start with the effect. We select the first clip and then go to the color module of DaVinci Resolve. We apply a node with the depth map effect, just like we did in the previous examples. In this case, we want to place text behind the person, so we'll have to select only the silhouette of the person to be able to place it on top of the text. To achieve this, we need to have the depth map in black and white, as in the previous examples. Selecting the completely black background and the completely white silhouette, adjusting the values of the far limit and near limit. Perfect, we have it. We deactivate the option to show depth map. We right-click on the node panel and add the alpha output. The alpha output is this blue circle on the right. We connect the blue square of the effect node to the alpha output. And there you have it. We have the person selected without the background. We go back to the editing module of DaVinci Resolve. Now we have a video clip with the person without the background, and the second video clip that has the background. Great. Now placing text behind the person is super easy. We place the video clip without the background on track 3. And then we place the original video with the background just below it, on track 1. On track 2, we must place our title, or whatever you want. You can also add an image, a logo, another video, anything. To add a title, we go to Effects, expand the toolbox, select Titles, and now we click on Text or Text Plus. Click and drag it to track 2. We now have the text behind the person. Now, customize the title to your liking. Modify the size, typography, color. It was easy, right? And it's a really striking effect. To finish this tutorial, I've decided to add an explanation of how to solve common errors that may appear when using the depth map, since it's very likely that you'll encounter errors like these. In this example, I've already finished the depth map, and I'm going to highlight the selection I made with a green color so that you can see the errors clearly. On the right side of the wall, there's an error. We can see that the depth map selection is having issues in that area. The left side also has some errors, but to a lesser extent. Perfect. Let's start by fixing this wall error, as it's the most obvious. We're going to correct the errors manually. The first thing you should do is select the depth map effect node, activate the invert box, and then make the selection in the depth map. In this case, I want to have the background selected, so it's fine as it is. To fix the wall error, we select the node where we made the changes, that is, the node where I colored everything green. We go to the Windows menu, and now we'll add a mask to select the part of the wall that has the error. Let's create the mask. Click on the pen icon, and then place the mouse cursor on the viewer and click the left mouse button, selecting the entire part of the wall that has the error. Great! Once the mask is finished, we need to invert it by clicking on this icon here. By inverting the mask, we can see how this part of the wall now appears correctly, and all that's left is to track the mask, so that the mask follows the movement of the wall throughout the video. To do this, we go to the tracker panel, and we click on this icon with two arrows to track the movement of the mask throughout the video. And DaVinci Resolve will start tracking the entire movement. We can see how the mask is following the wall. Once it's done, we make sure that the mask is correct throughout the entire video, and we can adjust its size to cover this area here. Perfect! We solved the problem with the wall selection. Now, to solve the small gap that wasn't selected by the depth map, I have a simple solution in mind. We'll create a new correction node and connect it. Great! In this new node, I'm going to create a mask right in the gap where the background is visible. And now, I just have to apply the same effect to this node. That is, put a green color. But, for example, if we had blurred the background, we would have to apply the same blur effect. It's important to remember to track the movement of the mask so that it follows the same movement of the video, as we explained earlier. I hope this tutorial's been helpful to you and that you can use all these effects in your videos. As always, I'm leaving you my free DaVinci Resolve course with over 50 tutorials, all for free. See you in the next video.